In Italy, one of the planet's most potentially dangerous volcanoes lies hidden in plain sight. There, west of Mount Vesuvius, continuing westwards past the city of Naples, are a series of large craters and caldera scarps which stick out in the landscape like a sore thumb. And yes, those are homes, buildings, sports stadiums, and even large cities located in the center of them. These mark the dozens of geologically young vents which formed from the Campi Flegrei volcano, but these vents help hide the fact that this entire region, including much of the adjacent bay, marks the site of two supermassive calderas. These calderas each formed in catastrophically large eruptions which devastated the surrounding landscape for as much as 100 miles in every direction. Since more than 300,000 people today live within the caldera rim, and 40 eruptions have occurred within this boundary during the Holocene epoch, you can see why Campi Flegrei is one of the most potentially dangerous volcanoes on the planet. While it is true that Campi Flegrei has produced at least 7 catastrophically large eruptions in the past, the vast majority of its eruptions in recent times were 1,000 to 10,000 times smaller than these events. Before I display this volcano's recent eruptive history, I want to quickly mention the elephant in the room. Since December of 2016, the Campi Flegrei volcano has been at not a green, but at a raised alert level of yellow. This alert level has been maintained because since then the site known as Solfatara that is filled with fumaroles has marked the center of a moderate intensity episode of ground deformation via uplift, rising at a variable rate which has recently averaged 6 inches or 15 centimeters a year. This uplift is caused by the migration of magma from a deeper magma chamber at 8 to 11 kilometers depth rising to and filling a laccolith-like sill at 3.5 kilometers depth which pushes overlying ground upwards. While sustained uplift of this magnitude would be highly concerning at the vast majority of world volcanoes, it is not a Campi Flegrei due to its history, where dramatic uplift and subsidence episodes have occurred fairly commonly, with some areas having risen and fallen by as much as 40 meters. While Campi Flegrei does have enough melt composition to theoretically produce an eruption, it in my opinion almost certainly won't anytime soon, as the amount of uplift is too small by an order of magnitude, with prior eruptions largely occurring after meters to tens of meters per year of uplift for multiple years. Any current potential evacuation talks are not due to the likelihood of an eruption occurring, but rather due to buildings not being designed to be uplifted unevenly, with this and associated earthquakes posing a potential hazard. With that out of the way, here is a brief timeline of all Holocene epoch eruptions which have occurred from Campi Flegrei, or the period from 9700 BCE up until the most recent eruption in 1538. This timeline will display the type and size of each eruption, the craters or features they left behind, and vent names. I want to note that some of the BCE dates are rounded to the nearest 25 or 50 years. Note how active Campi Flegrei was between 2700 BCE and 1700 BCE.